Welcome to the anatomy lecture series. Today I am going to start the first lecture of first module. While listening to this lecture, I strongly recommend you to read your standard textbooks as well as actively participate in your dissections. Let's start the lecture. Anatomy is one of the major basic science subjects that you learn as a medical student. Anatomy is a challenging subject for most of the students. To overcome these difficulties, there are several methods that you can follow. This was my method when I was a medical student, that is, drawing pictures. It was really successful for me. If you are happy, you can follow this method. The first lecture is axilla. What is axilla? It is the space between upper arm and the side of the thorax. It is somewhat pyramid in shape. Axilla bounds anteriorly and posteriorly by the axillary folds, and from upper it communicates with the posterior triangle of the neck, and floor is formed by the axillary fascia. As I mentioned earlier, axilla is somewhat pyramid in shape, so it has four walls, apex and the base. So let's see what are the boundaries of the axilla. This is the inferior view of transverse section of the axilla. Now I am going to mark anterior, posterior, medial and the lateral walls. Anterior, and this is posterior, medial and the lateral aspect of the axilla. In this diagram you can't see all structures of the axillary wall, but I will mention all the structures that you can't see in this diagram. Laterally, I have drawn the upper part of humerus with intertubicular groove. Medially, you can see the fourth rib. This is the pectoralis major muscle in anterior aspect, and this pectoralis major muscle is originated from the medial half of the clavicle, the sternum and the upper sixth of the costal cartilage, and inserted into the lateral lip of the bicipital groove of the humerus. Pectoralis minor muscle is located underneath the pectoralis major muscle. It is originated from the third to fifth ribs near their costal cartilages and inserted into the medial board and superior surface of the coracoid process of the scapula. In addition, the subclavius muscle and the clavipectoral fascia involve the formation of anterior wall of the axilla. Clavipectoral fascia is a strong fascia situated under cover of the clavicular portion of the pectoralis major muscle. It occupies the interval between the pectoralis minor and subclavius and protects the axillary vein, artery and the nerve. Subclavius muscle arises from the first rib at its costal cartilage and inserted into the subclavian groove in the middle one-third of the inferior surface of the clavicle. Now I am labeling the pectoralis major and minor muscle. This is the posterior wall and this is the scapula. Posterior wall of the axilla is formed by three muscles. These are subscapularis, teres major and tendon of latissimus dorsi. Subscapularis muscle is originated from the subscapular fossa and inserted into the lesser tuberosity of the humerus. Then the teres major muscle is originated from the inferior angle of the scapula and inserted into the bicipital groove. And other muscle is latissimus dorsi. Tendon of the latissimus dorsi involves the formation of posterior wall of the axilla. The tendon of the latissimus dorsi muscle is attached to the intertubicular sulcus of the humerus. Now carefully look the labeling of the components of the posterior wall of the scapula. This is subscapularis muscle, Posterior is major muscle. And the tendon of the latissimus dorsi muscle. Let's see the medial wall components. Medial wall convex laterally and it is formed by the upper part of serratus anterior muscle. Serratus anterior muscle is originated from the superior 8 or 9th rib and inserted into the vertebral border and inferior angle of the scapula. Here I label the serratus anterior muscle. Also the medial wall of the axilla is formed by the upper 4th ribs with their intercostal muscles. So this is the 4th rib. There are several structures in the lateral wall. First I am labeling the humerus and scapula which is in the posterior wall of the axilla. The lateral wall of the axilla is formed by the lips of intertubicular groove of humerus, coracobrachialis muscle and the short head of biceps brachii. In the lateral wall, coracobrachialis muscle and the short head of the biceps are not seen in this picture because coracobrachialis muscle origins at the tip of coracoid process of the scapula and inserted into the middle third of the medial surface of the humerus. And short head of the biceps brachii muscle origins at tip of coracoid process of the scapula and inserted into the tuberosity of radius and the fascia of the forearm via bicipital aponeurosis. Keep in mind, this is the inferior view of the transverse section of axilla. So you can't see the apex of the axilla, which is formed by clavicle, upper board of the scapula and the outer board of the first rib. Let's look at the contents of the axilla. This is axillary sheath. Axillary sheath is an extension of the prevertebral fascia of the deep cervical fascia. Axillary artery and the cords of the brachial plexus are within the axillary sheath. Red color dot is the axillary artery. Now I draw the cords of the brachial plexus. This is the axillary vein. Remember that axillary vein is not the component of axillary sheath. Green color dots are axillary lymph nodes. These lymph nodes are also located outside of the axillary sheath. Now I am labeling the contents of the axilla. This is axillary sheath. This is axillary artery which is in the axillary sheath. This is axillary vein. These are the cords of the brachial plexus. These are also within the axillary sheath. These are axillary lymph nodes. This is the general view of axilla. As a medical student, you should know how to draw this diagram because there are several clinically important aspects in this region. So, keep on practicing. All the best. Thank you very much for listening. Please join with the next lecture on brachial plexus.